patient education on diabetes. This was a really interesting question. I thought it was a lot of fun when I read this because I could see the coder rolling her eyes thinking, what are you thinking? So they have a patient or a client with type 1 diabetes, and she's getting 3 encounter forms a day for when the nurse gives the client her insulin, and every time she marks the box for administering insulin, which is the proper thing to do, and also marks the 98960 box for patient education. Now, this is, I'm assuming, like a home health type visit, and I did home health for a long time, and you have the RN's notes, and then you have the nurse's notes, and then and if it's like everything else, if it's not written down, it's not done. It sounds like this nurse was wanted to make sure got credit for everything she was doing. Okay, I have a question. The nurse says here at our facility, do education and training, self-management with our clients, which are children, and you know, type 1 diabetes, again, especially for children and the parents, a lot of training is involved in there. So she went on to say they are this nurse is pushing 98960 for every nurse visit note times 3 a day. I don't think we can bill 3 times a day every single day. This kid is in our care for education of diabetes. Can we? Our clients are here for 6 to 9 months. That's an awful lot of patient education on diabetes. Well, let's look at the code itself first. 98960, education and training for patient self-management by a qualified non-physician healthcare professional using a standardized curriculum face-to-face with the patient, could include caregiver or family, each 30 minutes individual patient. Okay, there's other codes for additional time, or additional patients, excuse me. A physician or other healthcare professional provides education and training to a patient on how to manage a disease, injury, or other health problem. Now, this is a guidelines that are right before the 98960 codes. So the manual, you know, they'll have specific guidelines related to following codes, and then they'll have more guidelines listed. So that's where I got this information here. Okay, it went on to say family members of the patient or other caregivers may also be present. Makes sense, right? The instruction is based on a standard curriculum, though it may be modified slightly as circumstances dictate. Okay, definitely they're being very clear that you have to have a curriculum, a beginning and an end of goals you want your patient to have learned. That's what I think of the curriculum is, you know, not just, oh, today we're going to talk about cleaning your, you know, disposing of your needles, and oh, tomorrow we're going to talk about how to give injections and practice on oranges, and oh, today let's talk about, you know, how to pick up your insulin from the pharmacy. It's not like that. It's going to be standard. Now, let's see. The CPT manual is very clear on this. The purpose of the education and training service is to teach the patient, and it may include caregivers, how to effectively self-manage the patient's disease. Education and training related to subsequent reinforcement or due to changes in the patient's condition or treatment plan are reported in the same manner as the original education and training. Again, this gives you a little leeway because they're saying, you know, you're going to train your patient, and let's say you've got a young boy here and he looks to be about 8, 9 years old, you know, and they have very short attention spans, but this is very critical. You don't mess with diabetes, and, you know, he can get sick very quickly if he doesn't understand the concept of exercises versus the amount of eating he does and the sleep and so on and so forth. And what constitutes exercise, because sometimes just playing out in the backyard may be more exercise than you think. So you educate the patient, then you've got to educate the parents, and then you got to educate the grandparents probably. And so, again, this could be spread out, especially if you're doing home visits and the grandparents aren't there on a specific day. Okay. Let's see. Oh, and also changes. Let's say your the patient gets an ear infection and has to take an antibiotic. Blood levels go up and down differently when you're on antibiotics or even a steroid. You know, they might put a child on to dry things up. And so, again, more education would be needed for the parent, especially. The qualifications of a non-physician healthcare professional and the content of the educational and training program must be consistent with guidelines or standards established or recognized by a physician society, non-physician healthcare professional, society, association, or other approved source. Okay, again, it's not really ambiguous because they're telling you need to have a standard training plan set in place for maybe adults, teenagers, children, caregivers, you know, parents, grandparents, school, you know, people if the child is in public school. So this is where you can come into some problems, though. This is what I was just thinking off the kind of off the top of my head. But so your nurse is using 989-960 for every visit that she goes out, and she goes out 3 times a day to do injections, and is going to do that for 6 months. Well, then an auditor comes in and says, you know, each time you use 989-960, you better document the time you start, the time you stop the education, not the nurse's visit, not the time the nurse's visit with home health. It's very clear you've got to do the time in and the time out. But this is separate. This is the education part of the visit. So if you got there at 10 o'clock in the afternoon and you started your education at 10:30 and you ended the education at 10:45 and the visit was over at 10:50, you know, that then you've documented how much time and education was given during that visit. Describe the education given so that it shows change from previous education given. Be very specific and include copies of the literature given. This is very important. I know the nurses used to do this quite a bit with home health. And let's say that the patient, especially physical therapy, they were training them, the physical therapist would attach a photocopies of the documentation that she gave the patient to show them the exercises that they were to use while they're recovering from a broken hip after they just got home from that. You know, and it was all on her note so that an auditor could come through and say, yes, I see that you did all of this work. So I would think that you would need to have that if you're giving education and it's specific curriculum. If you don't want to attach all of that, then you would have a separate notebook for type 1 diabetic education for a child, type 1 education, you know, for the caregiver, and then say refer to diabetic education book, page 1, section 2 was given on, you know, 8, 15, 14, and then you could document it that an auditor could come back and say, okay, I see. You went out in the morning and you did this education for the mother. You went out in the afternoon when you gave the shot, you educated the child. When you went out in the third injection in the evening, the grandmother was there, and so you gave education for them. This is the documentation you gave them. And then your plan would be, you know, tomorrow when you go out in the morning, you know, blah, 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 blah. Be as specific as you possibly can. Okay, and let's see. Okay, so I had put in here it's very important to show that there is education given 3 times a day for 30 minutes every day for that 6 months period. And most of your patients, if it's like home health, they are going to be there for 6 months. They've gotten approval for 6 months with the insurance. And the insurance company itself is going to want to know, what were you training, you know, all of this time, 3 times a day. But if you have a set curriculum where you can say, you know, okay, I know I'm going out 3 times a day times, however many times that is in 6 months, then you can say a standard policy. It's the notebooks there or whatever education you're doing, and you're being very specific. You can even write down the questions that the patients had or the parent had. That would mean why you would go to 30 minutes or beyond 30 minutes. Well, you know, really, in my mind, this is something that's a compliance officer needs to establish in an office. That's where they come in and, you know, train the office staff, train the clinicians, and make sure that you have something like that notebook for education. And I'm sure diabetes isn't the only education that you're doing for children. It could be other, it could be a wound vac. It could be, you know, a child who's chemotherapy and stuff, and the nurse has to come out and do special training during that time. But you can have a notebook for all of those different things, and then if that is in fact what they do, you're covered. If they can't do that or can't document, then I would definitely say don't be clicking that code on your little sheet. Okay. Anyway, that was pretty interesting. I enjoyed looking up that one.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.